The devil is a liar. I got back on my feet again. I started praying. I pray. I wish I could sing. But when I in my process, I can sing for God. I said to my God, the only time I will fall, except you are not a tomb, that's why I will fall. But as long as you are on my tomb, say to me, the devil is a liar. I started praying. Oh my God, people, my little brother was there. He said, I'm feeling cold. I'm feeling the cold one. I shut the door because he was talking. I shut the door on myself. I started praying. And God have it, before we make up our mind, they said the old lady got her purse back.
She's the best now, and I just thank God encourage them, please.
Giving me a new foundation. I'm the first child of the family that is giving me a new foundation. So there's this particular thing I was struggling with financially. So when I get to this particular stage, something will happen and we just...
You have fallen from ladder. You have broken his leg. He cannot walk again. Come and take your sheep back. And we'll give you his own sheep too. So this is how God has fought for me. And by the grace of God, this stage that the devil has put me in, I've seen myself, I've already passed that level, and I want to thank God for that.
Thank you.
Since my life, I've been facing challenges and
circumstances where God have lifted me out himself. So now I am in Australia here. There are still challenges that I'm facing because it was not the mindset that I came with that. It's not what I think back home that I'm seeing here. But when I remember what God has done for me back home, when I faced his near-death experience, how he delivered me and made a way for me, I still have that confidence in my heart that today, that in this Australia, no matter how the trouble or the challenges might come, that very big God that I have is still here with me. And I want to thank God as well for his mercy upon my life, because he's already showing me mercy now. The things that I'm finding difficult, God are already putting things in place.
Amen.
To meet all those challenges. And I just want to give all glory to God.
Amen. Your testimony shall be permanent in the name of Jesus. Let's clap our hands for the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. I'm sorry, I'm going to join them in singing as well. Come and see the Lord is good. Come and see the Lord is good.
As a casual,
And I was applying, I keep applying to places where I think I'll get a job. But unfortunately, everywhere, sometimes they will not even call me for an interview, not to talk of even getting to know what I can offer them. And some people, they'll get me an interview, will laugh, will, like, they'll make me comfortable. But then at the end of the day, they'll be like, sorry, we regret. So I was just at a point of just giving up when I didn't even know when I applied for this job. So they called me for interview. At first, I didn't tell my husband because I was like, maybe this is just going to be like any other ones. And I don't want him to feel bad for me. So it was the day he went to work. So I did the interview behind his back. I didn't tell him anything. About 2-3 days later, one of my reference called me to say, they sent a reference check for him. And that was when I told my husband, I'm like, I think I did an interview 3 days ago. And he was like, okay. I was like, for the reference check to be sent to the reference, I think something is going on. I'm like, I don't know, but anyway, let's see what will happen. So 4 days later, they called me and they said, hi Eunice, we're really impressed with your interview. We would love to employ you. It was just like a dream. But thank God. Praise the Lord, people.
Thank God for his blessings. May your testimony be powerful to the Lord. Hallelujah. Everything was affecting me. And towards the end of last year, I started having high blood pressure. I was like, there's no high blood pressure in my family. What's going on? So I couldn't rest. I was restless. Everything was just turning around suddenly. So, but unfortunately, I had to, go back to church, meet my pastor, started praying. And at some point, my pastor told me, there's no problem anywhere. What's going on? Is it that you are committing some sin that you're not telling me? I said, that they have no sign. He said, okay, just let's wait unto the Lord. So, December, I look into UK again. And my wife said, no, this paper is going to come out. And by the glory of God, January 9th this year, Australia released my brother, before I can come, you have to come to Nigeria. Let's have a, at least a wedding, even if it is just a registry. And she came, there was troubles, family members, because I'm the last child of about 33. My dad gave me today. So I couldn't tell everybody. I did everything my own way, and God took absolute control. Everybody was like, bro, it's okay, just do it. It's okay, just go with your wife. Nobody questioned my decision till I relocated there. And finances, God was all over there for me. And luckily, I said, my name is Testimony. I got to Australia February 18th, and I stayed with the family here for 2 weeks. And the moment we reached the countryside we are, I got a job within a week. My wife was like, you can't take this job, I said, I'm going to take it. And after spending 3 months in the countryside, I said, will you come from Nigeria to Australia and live in the village? No. We are moving to city. He said, no, city life is this, is that we are going. And we took the decision, we put our loads in our small car, we released our house, we came, and our family here said, you can't come to Melbourne. Go to some regional area. I said, no, leave them, we will do this, God will speak to us. And we planned to spend 1 week with them, that if within 1 week we don't get the house, we'll move to an hotel, that whatever it wants to be, we will face it. And we can't tell them that we actually want to move to Melbourne. So from their place, we go for our house inspection. And luckily, within a week, we inspected 4 houses. The last house, we got it. And that same week, we were given the key. And everything just went smoothly. And we moved to the house on Sunday, and I started working in Melbourne on Monday. Praise the Lord.
Going in now. was me, you know, at that time. I was like in this dark space where I, even now, I'm struggling to really trust. I'm just believing God to guide me, to lead me to the right place that He God wants me to for my feet to be planted, not because I want to sing for formality or I do have a gift, but it's not my gift, it's God's gift. And I want it to be used in the right place. And I always say, God, lead me to the right place that you want me to grow. It's not because of men, but because of your will. So when that happened to me, I did everything that the Lord has asked us to do, settling things amicably when things happened, but it didn't happen that way. I said, God, well, if this is your will that this end here, and I walk away. I mean, I was not really spiritually rooted. I mean, I was very hurt at that time this year. So I'm just believing in God that He who has started the good work, He will end it. Amen.
Amen. We cannot watch in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Shout hallelujah! Tell somebody, finally, God is happy with you.
Finally, God is happy with you.
Alright, I will let you know why later. I have two testimonies. The first one is healing. For about more than 15 years now, whenever the month is about to come to an end, this headache, weakness, pain will start. And that is the time I used to fast. But I was always in pain. But to God be the glory. 4 months ago, God visited me. The reason why I didn't come to give this testimony is I was trying to check. Whether the sickness is still there. Alright. I want to give glory to God that I'm perfectly okay. During that time, my wife is very sensitive. She will know that. But I'm still preaching, I'm still on, working, doing everything that I need to do, still fasting. But that thing, you know, Apostle said, there's a thorn in my flesh. Sometimes you don't know what men of God are going through. And I want to thank God that I am whole, perfect. Hallelujah! The second testimony is about Minister Miracle. So Monday, she gave back to me a bouncing new ball. The reason why I am sharing this testimony on our journey is because she's one of the foundation of this church and she's very close to me. She will come and say everything because her testimony is big. So but when she took in, the devil and this child will not come. But to God be the glory. The God that did not, that will not give some people said, it will not happen. But I say, God, not my own myself. That I've called on this in this church will not put us to shame. But today, the baby is doing well. The mother is doing well. Bless us.
Exalted Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the healing, we thank you for the miracle job, we thank you for the journey in mercy here and there. Father, we say be that exalted Lord, in the name of Jesus. Now commit all these testimonies into your hands. They are permanent in the name of Jesus. For those that are trusting for one or two, please speak into their situation, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah! If you are ready to take your Jericho, shout hallelujah! Amen. Today's service is a little bit different, but I'm happy for all those testimonies. That is why I said God is happy with us. And I know that more testimonies we have now in Jesus' name. Now, quickly, we want to give thanksgiving offering. Amen? So when we give thanksgiving offering, then we will now move to dance. That is the Jericho dance. And I will come up with a few minutes. We don't have much time. But we adjust everything. Amen? So because like some of us don't know that in the Redeemed Christian Church of God, our Father, assembly, every first Sunday, we take three types of offering, Sunday love offering, and the tithes, and thanksgiving offering. Okay? And that is the section that we are now. So I want you to package your thanksgiving offering. So you have to target thanksgiving. So let us give unto the Lord, because our God is worthy of our praise. So when we give that, then we'll now come. So that means we are taking some of your time. Okay? You will just use so that we can be able to close as soon as possible. Amen? Are we ready? Let's give our thanksgiving offering. Then I will pray on it, then take our Jericho that God has prepared for us. Amen. Over to you.
Hallelujah.
That's the section. That's the last section, then I will come up.
Some house food that can not eat, some can eat that has no food. We have food and we can eat. Glory to you. Some can see that can we
This morning. You know it! Bless us!
barrenness is falling. That will have delay of your barrenness on your visa is falling.
Are you ready? Yeah. You will get that job. Yeah. You will get your choice.
a shout, the world will collapse, and then we enter into eternal, and make war with us today. I decree over your life, over your life, forever.
Amen.
Spiritually forever.
Amen.
Maritally forever. Sister Eunice 2, Sister Gifts, Sister Onye, and